question is, we also heard that in Poland there were hired in the last year 75,000 drivers from Ukraine and Belarus and many other countries as well. Do they have to give the exam for the CBC and CBI in Polish, or they are allowed to have the examination in other language, as English or Russian on their own?
Politics are saying it's a very good question. To be honest, I don't know if the language is Polish or not. To be perfectly honest, I don't know. I can tell you that after the conference I need to check it. I don't know.
Do you have any Ukrainian driver?
Yes. We have quite. You know, in Poland we are having circa about 3,000 rules of transport. Not only drivers, it's actually quite a significant number of employees we employ in the warehouse. Not only warehouse, also IT, there are quite a lot of people coming from this industry in Poland. So, yeah, quite a significant number of Ukrainian citizens are already employed by our land in Poland.
They speak Polish?
Yeah, the language by me is quite small in terms of our country, but it's pretty understandable. They say that 3 months is enough to learn Polish if you are Ukrainian in Poland.
And one last question. How do the German companies, German customers, see you? As an Eastern company, as a Polish company, as a Dutch company, or as a German company?
It's a very sensitive question. Okay. As it was presented, and as it was even written below the picture of Mr. Rebala, who was receiving the award, we are originally a Dutch company. And the holding as such is registered in Netherlands. Of course, the main development of the group happened in the 90s in Poland, but I think that in the German market we are more considered as a Dutch company than the Polish.
Do the German companies pay you differently compared to a German transport company?
No, definitely not. If yes, then we wouldn't be able to develop on this market because to pay for subcontractors and people. No, we are simply acting as any other LSP on the market.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.